The Chicago Week House exists in some of the toughest neighborhoods in Chicago. A lot of people hear about the gun violence and the gangs, and we intentionally embed our programs and our communities there. Where you have the mission of using sustainability to alleviate inner city poverty. And we do that by operating social enterprises that involve at-risk youth, that teach them STEM skills, as well as small business skills. So the Eco House experience, I heard one person describe it as being like Grand Central Station in a house. Eco House is literally in a home. Kids come in and out, you know, throughout the day. We try to treat the kids and the families that we build relationships with like an extension of our own family. They come in and they really learn hands-on what it's like, for example, to do urban ag in their community, what renewable energy is and how to apply it in a way that not only facilitates clean energy, but facilitates economic and community development. They work with 3D printing, so they get the experience of working with more technical machinery, which is good preparation for them if they were to go into a more, you know, intensive manufacturing field. We really approach it from a way of like looking at what we feel like are the emerging industries of the future and trying to get our kids introduced to that now so that by the time those fields are more mature, our kids will be the ones able to take advantage of it. What's hard about this is everything. We didn't have a lot of money when we started. We didn't have like a lot of connections, so it's heavy lifting every day. But you know, when you're around like really passionate and dedicated people all the time, and you see like the sacrifices that they're making, it gives you a lot of hope, not just for, you know, the inner city, but for humanity in general. With this journey, just meeting other people who refuse to like succumb to like fear and pessimism, you know, looking at the news and being like, oh, what's the point of even waking up today? Those are the people we hang out with. As a matter of fact, most people we hang out with don't own a TV because they're just like so plugged in with like the work they're doing and so committed to building that future and trying to usher in a better future. So I really have a lot of hope for our country and for our planet. I think our best days are ahead of us.